Hi viewer, welcome to Eden TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, Lesson 4. The topic it is Internal Land Forming Processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Modoni. Welcome. We look at our lesson goals. We are going to look at the continental drift theory. So by the end of the lesson, you should be able to understand the continental drift theory by Alfred. So we start by looking at the theory, the way it states, how it states, or explaining the theory. This theory, it was brought up by Alfred Wenger, was the one who brought up that theory. He said that the earth was initially one, that is one land mass, which was referred to as the boundary. This one land mass was surrounded by a great sea, which was referred to as the Pandalasa. Pandalasa, it from was Sima, while Pangaea, it was sea. So we end two from the word go. Pangaea, which was the sea, and Sima, which was the Pandalasa. During the time of Precambrian period, the Pangaea broke into two blocks. That is the Laurasia to the north and Gondwanaland to the south. The two blocks were separated by a narrow ocean, which was referred to as the Tigris. Now remember, Pangaea is not one Pangaea. Now we have the Laurasia and the Gondwanaland. And we have the Tethys, which is a ocean that separates the two. Let us see the way they were. As you can be able to see, that during the Precambrian era, the Pangaea became. We have the Laurasia, which went to the north, as you can be able to see from that image, and then the Gondwanaland, which went to the south. Then the Tethys and the Pandalasa, the water that was surrounding the other part of the world. Then we come to the Mesozoic era. Laurasia, which went to the north, broke into two, giving us the Eurasia and the North America, while the Gondwanaland split into four. That is the South America, we also have Africa, we have the Antarctica and Australia. And these are the continents we have even up to date. As you can be able to see from the image, we have the Mesozoic period, we have the North America, and the Eurasia, which is the Europe and Asia. The two came from Eurasia. Then we have the South America, we also have Africa, we also have the Antarctica and the Australia. These were now, they came from the Gondwanaland. And that is the reason as to why you can see the four of them are in the southern part of the world. That marks the end of our lesson. As you can be able to see, we have the activity there that is telling us state the evidence of the continental drift theory. So you're supposed to explain the four steps. Then from there now, you can be able to get your marks. Then the reference, it is still KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 2. For more information, you can contact us, get us through either SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. Or you can get us through the Twitter. Stay tuned to Erin TV. Thank you.